Otto Wallin versus Dominic Brazil. Going to take place next weekend, man, and I'm hyped because of that, not gonna lie. They fought some really, really big names. Otto Wallin, well, he fought, as much as I remember, Tyson Fury for 12 rounds. Very, very high quality fighter, great Swedish professional boxer. Dominic Brazil fought Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder. These are the best guys in the division. Dominic Brazil, 6'7", 81.5 inches is his reach, 20 wins, 18 by the way of a knockout, and 2 losses. The guy defeated Izu Ogono, Eric Molina, Carlos Negron, Amir Mansour, Fred Cassi, Victor Bisbal, and many, many other high-quality fighters. But yeah, he is a finisher, but he can get finished. Very, very entertaining fighter to watch because his bouts very rarely go judges' scorecards, go to judges' scorecards or decision. On the other side, Otto Wallin is 6'6", and his reach is 78 inches, which means he's gonna face reach disadvantage in this fight. 21 wins, 14 by way of a KO, 1 loss, 1 no contest, and he is the former boxing Nordic silver medalist. He scored many wonderful, lovely victories, and he holds, for example, victories over Adrian Grenet, Travis Kaufman. He is the former vacant WBA Continental Heavyweight Champ. He also defeated Srdan Govedarica. I mean, in Europe, he is one of the most dominant fighter ever. Unfortunately, his fight against Nick Isner went to judges. It was ruled no contest because of accidental headbutt. But I've got to say that Otto Wallin is a very, very prospective fighter. The point is that Dominic Brazil is very much vulnerable to right hand, as well as you've noticed in the fight against Deontay Wilder. Otto Wallin is a southpaw fighter, and he really, really gave a hard time to Tyson Fury. In that fight, he really gave a hard time to Tyson Fury, and Tyson Fury, now a champ, he really had a hard time with Otto Wallin, especially because of this southpaw stance. On the other side, Dominic Brazil got knocked out by Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua, but it's never easy to fight a left-handed fighter, especially because of the fact that Otto Wallin constantly ducks under and constantly moves to the right, which might be at least a problem for a right-handed fighter. And Dominic Brazil's movement, it's not to the left, you know. When he moves, he is not cutting angles well. That's one of the technical problems he is gonna have to overcome when he squares off against Otto Wallin. So I think Dominic Brazil has better knockout power. But if he doesn't finish Otto Wallin within first 3-4 rounds, it's gonna be a big problem for him, because Otto Wallin is better when it comes to stamina. I mean, I watched his fight against Rafael Zumbano. It was a 10-round war, but he really fought well against Adrian Granat, however. I watched a bit, but he was looking pretty much well, but I was skipping that fight, didn't have time to watch the whole fight. Dominic Brazil, on the other side, he only fought 2 times on judges' scorecards or decision. He fought for 10 rounds once, for 8 rounds once. So I believe as the fight progresses that Otto Wallin is going to take over. Plus, Otto Wallin is known as a slow starter who pushes the pace and increases the pace as the time goes by. So my prediction for this fight is going to be Otto Wallin, despite reach disadvantage and some problems with long range striking. I see Otto Wallin winning the fight inside the pocket. I think we might see a stoppage in this fight, but I'm not sure. If the stoppage happens, then it's going to be Dominic Brazil's victory, but chances of stoppage are less than 30% in this fight. My final pick for this is going to be Otto Wallin.